Well, here we are again, folks. Spoiler season. Magic Core Set 2020 is just around the corner, and it's time for Lansego to start offering some daily insights. Let's get right into the swing of things, talking about three cards that were spoiled last week. Chandra, Novice Pyromancer, continues the trend of uncommon Planeswalkers, four converted mana costs with an elemental twist, no doubt cluing us into some of the shenanigans we're going to see as spoiler season progresses. The minus one is what really got me excited, though. Mana ramp in red is a very dangerous proposition, and I expect that this will be widely abused. Chandra, Acolyte of Flame, at rare for a three converted mana cost Chandra Planeswalker effectively creates the catalyst for a Chandra tribal deck. If it was already kind of a thing, it is definitely a thing now. She has two zero abilities, and her first gives us the ability to ramp each red Planeswalker we control. She makes 3-1 elementals right on curve to our 4-drop Chandra and helps us recur instant and sorcery spells. Dynamite! Chandra, Awakened Inferno, is powerful, folks. 6 converted mana cost and cannot be countered, which means we are guaranteed at least one emblem on our opponent. This card is a brilliant red Planeswalker, and I expect that her ability to control the board and handle bigger, more problematic creatures and Planeswalkers will make her a staple in Standard from day one. Ajani, Strength of the Pride, was spoiled today, and short of literally reaching through your screen and shaking you in excitement, it will suffice to say that Ajani is back, baby. Massive life gain on the uptick, Ajani's Pride Mate tokens, and a one-sided wrath at the expense of losing our Ajani. What the actual expletive deleted? I cannot wait to get my hands on this card, and I am already testing with it. Watsy is apparently going all in on Chandra, or at least the spoilers are telling us so. I have a sneaking suspicion that they will be going all in on several Planeswalkers. Chandra Spitfire is a reprint from Core 2011. Plays well in burn decks, and will likely get slotted into some type of UR Phoenix list. At the very least, the Spitfire may be a good limited card. We get an entirely new mythic in Cavalier of Flame, and a hard commitment to red. 5 converted mana costs, 3 red specific for a 6-5 with some gross Anthem-style effects that you can pump through. You can wheel your entire hand on the ETB trigger, and this card is encouraging, no, insisting that we find a way to fill our graveyard with lands. My sense of curiosity is heightened by this spoiler, and I'm sure Debo is already finding ways to break it open. Let's sit tight and see where this goes, okay? Chandra's Regulator represents a wave of Planeswalker-specific legendary artifacts. It only makes sense that the main characters of our story would have specialized tools. So let me get this straight. I can continuously loot for 1 colorless mana. I can pay 1 colorless mana and give my opponent 2 emblems off of Chandra Awakened Inferno. This card seems broken to me. Pre-order your copies now, folks. Believe me. Chandra's Embercap taps for a red mana. Caveat is that the mana can only be used for elemental and Chandra spells. Move along. Nothing to see here. Dragon Mage is seeing a reprint out of Scourge. This card feels old in both terms of technical power and mana cost, but let's not kid ourselves. At the top of a dragon deck, this card is an ender. I just worry it may not be fast enough to contend with the speed of today's game. Flame Sweep is actually a pretty nice sweeper. It might be as close as we get to Pyroclasm, and the added upside of avoiding our own flying creatures' death is, well, interesting. Dread Presence gets the juices flowing, doesn't it? A 3-3 for 4 mana is acceptable, but when you throw in the added benefit of draw tempo and direct damage on swamp ETB triggers, I start to get really excited. Scapeshift, Crucible, Ramp Synergies, hello? Is it just me? Scheming Symmetry is brilliant. I love this one drop, especially in a world where Thought Erasure is our turn to play. Be careful what you draw, folks. Disfigure gets a reprint out of Zendikar in Core Set 2020. Cool. I guess Moment of Cramping needed a replacement, and this'll do nicely. Yaruk's Fenlurker is exiling cards from our opponent's hands, as if hand destruction needed more help at this point. Seeing this new card makes me uneasy, at best. The card is a bomb in Limited, and how much play it will see in Constructed is totally up in the air, but exiling cards from the hand. Speaking of nasty hand destruction, Thought Distortion is powerful but overpriced at 6 mana. I can't even see this card being good in a ramp scenario. If it was 5 converted mana cost, it might be playable, and at 4 mana, it would be the bee's knees. But it isn't, so moving on. Wakeroot Elemental seems like the next logical step in the face of Nissa Who Shakes the World. These lands matter decks are interesting. 5-5 creatures with haste are scary. I feel like this card will see play in fringe circumstances. Certainly not high-level competitive play, but I've been wrong before. Hey! Thrashing Brontodon is seeing a reprint. cool. And unsummon. Neat. And negate. That's just super. Whoa. Disenchant. Cool. Ooh, now here we go. Angel of Vitality, a 3-drop angel, which Angel Tribal needed badly to become more viable in Standard. I love the additional life gain upside and the bonus to power and toughness when the qualifier is met. I will be playing this card, and you should too. Interesting that after all this time, color-specific answers are still being printed in Magic the Gathering. Devout Decree is cool, but very niche, and therefore not really easy to predict in terms of impact on the Standard metagame. Aether Gust is color-specific as well, at instant speed, placing red or green spells or permanents on the top or bottom of the library. Interesting, but again, as of yet, difficult to effectively gauge the impact on the Standard meta. We can likely find uses. What do you think? Atemsis, all-seeing. A new Sphinx is one of those weird cards that seems fun, but ends up being more frustrating to capitalize on than you might think. I love the draw two, discard one ability for 3 mana, but pulling off the win con is nigh on impossible. Will that stop us from trying to pull it off at Lansay Go? Absolutely not. Stay tuned. Octoprophet is an octopus with a scry trigger. Infuriate is a new 1-red instant that grants 3 power and 2 toughness. Hello, sweet cheeks. Granko has been waiting. Creeping Trailblazer is proof positive that WotC wants you to be playing a green and red elemental deck, probably something that uses Chandra and Nissa and some combination of efficiency and elemental shenanigans. Of course, not all core sets are meant solely for Standard. Empyrean Eagle is an outstanding ward for flying creatures. This card will see play. Risen Reef is tempting, but as of yet, we don't know how powerful the elemental game plan will be in core set 2020. Sure does feel like, in combination with Chandra, that maybe Teemer will be doing some wonky stuff, and the ramp Risen Reef provides will be welcomed with open arms. Loxodon Lifesinger is a crazy card. For 6 mana, we can reset our life total to the total combined toughness of all creatures we control. Man, it would have been nice to have this creature in core set 2019. I think it would have been an excellent addition to an Arcades Walls deck. Fortunately, High Alert is still around, and the brew potential remains. Iron Root Warlord is a card I fully expect to rocket in popularity and frequency of use. Token strategies in Standard have been needing one-off creatures like this, and 5 toughness for 3 mana is a bargain. Cryptic Caves, wow. Talk about an amazing card in combination with Crucible of Worlds. I have a funny feeling that this card could be broken, but just don't have the time in this video to talk about why. I'm sure we'll get to it in our conversations with the team eventually. Rien, Angel of Rebirth, is bringing back the Guild Pact in a serious way. Expect this card to see substantial amounts of brews and commander play. Standard will find uses, and angels are a staple for me. Not to mention 5/4 flyers are a total clock. The Anthem effect and restoration ability is out of control with this card. I love it. Love this card. Very exciting stuff. Kaikar Wind's Fury is a Jeskai powerhouse. We are creating spirit tokens that fly, and now the sweeper that avoids your flyers makes sense, doesn't it, folks? Red mana ramp for sacrificing spirits? What is happening? Also, if you haven't seen our Angels and Birdseed deck from a few months ago, head out to the site and check it out. Adding Kaikar makes that deck full on bonkers. Leyline of Sanctity was spoiled today, which means we're going to see Leyline reprints, which means Standard just got incredibly complicated. I love the idea of having Leylines back in Standard, as the raw power they represent from the beginning of the game takes us in entirely new directions. The best and most powerful card spoiled today is Corpse Knight. Might be a personal opinion, but talk about a banger. Notice it does not say non-token creature, which means we get to do some seriously obnoxious stuff with Alinda, with History of Benalia, with March of the Multitudes, with Finale of Glory. The list goes on and on and on, for a couple of months anyway. Also, all of those big token sorcery cards are really, really scary. Just think about it, folks. Corpse Knight will be a thing. Just wait and see. Corpse Knight. Well, that's it for Core Set 2020 Spoilers Day 1, June 17th, 2019. Stop by again tomorrow for Day 2 and click that subscribe button, please. Jeremy out.